The first few units are going to walk you through a variant of Gaussian elimination that is often referred to as Gauss-Jordan elimination. We'll start by showing how Gauss-Jordan elimination can be used to solve a linear system. We'll then show that you can use it to simultaneously solve several linear systems that have the same matrix associated with them. And then we're going to show how we can use that to then invert a matrix, which then slowly leads towards a practical algorithm that can be implemented. So let's get started. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to motivate everything with a concrete example that involves three equations and three unknowns. And let's see if you paid any attention. What needs to be done in order to transform this first linear system to the equivalent linear system below it? What you notice is that you should take row 2 and subtract off, let's see, minus 1 times the first row. So in other words, you should add the first two rows. And then you should take the third row and subtract off 2 times the first row. And what you get then is this system right here. And it's just a matter of doing the math right, and hopefully I did do this right. Okay, then let's take that second system and ask the question how to transform it into the equivalent system below it. Now, this is a little bit different because previously we would have only eliminated this term right here. Notice that now we're going to eliminate that term, but also this term right above here. And how are we going to do that? Well, eliminating this term is a matter of taking row 3 and subtracting off 1 times row 2. Eliminating this term is a matter of taking row 1 and subtracting off, let's see, minus 2 times row 2. And notice that that leaves the second row alone. And what you get is that this term and that term disappears. Let's do one more step. We now have the system that we arrived at in the previous step. The purpose of the game now is going to be to eliminate this term and that term. And the way we will do that is we will take row 1 and subtract off, let's see, minus 1 times row 3, which really means that we add this row to that row. And then we replace the second row by subtracting off 2 times the third row. And if you do the arithmetic right, then you end up with this system right here. Now this is kind of nice because you're starting to see that this is quite easy to solve. But actually we're going to do one more step and we're going to say how can we transform this system into this system right here, which is particularly easy because you can just read off what chi0, chi1, and chi2 must be. And the way we do that is we multiply this first row by 1/2. We multiply the second row by minus 1, and we multiply the third row, or the third equation, by 1. And when you do that, you end up with this right here. And lo and behold, this is the solution to the original linear system. Remember, as long as we take multiples of rows and add them to other rows, or scale rows or equations by non-zero scalars, we don't change the solution of the linear system. So what we have just done is we've taken the original system and through a sequence of steps we have changed it into a system that you can recognize as the identity times chi0, chi1, chi2 equal to the right hand side minus 1, minus 2, and let's see, 1. So what this is just a variant on Gaussian elimination. Previously with Gaussian elimination, we eliminated the terms that left us with an upper triangular system of linear equations. And this time we also eliminated terms above the diagonal, and we then in the end scaled the equations so that we were just left with having to read off what the final solution was. In the next couple of units, we're going to look at the same approach slightly differently, much like we did when we first introduced Gaussian elimination.